another port video. This is not exactly in port, but you get to it from port. That's the Valley of the Kings. Hi, I'm Jan Oatbridge, I'm the cruise queen. A few years ago, my husband and I discussed going on a river cruise because I wanted to visit the Valley of the Kings. I'm not getting any younger and I decided I wanted to go while I was still fit enough to do the walking that's required to go down into the tombs and back up again and so forth. So we were contemplating it, and then we came across a repositioning cruise, actually I believe with Royal Caribbean, that was going from Barcelona to Dubai via Egypt. It had actually come over from the States and it was going to China. Should I mention China now? Anyway, going to China, and so it stopped at a few different places on the way, and we picked it up in Barcelona. And the reason we did it is because we could go to Dubai, which was nice, but we also could go via Egypt, and it stopped at, I think, three ports in Egypt, and one of them was the port for Valley of the Kings. Now, I think the port was called Safaga, or something like that. I don't know how you say it. But all I know is we got off the ship. In fact, we booked this trip on ship. We made the decision, as I've mentioned in other videos, that if you're gonna travel a long way from the ship, especially in a country that, you know, you're not too sure of, that you're better off going with the ship, because it was a 3-hour journey each way. And it meant that we would definitely get the ship on the way back. And I thought, you never know with unscrupulous people, they could take us there and then get us there and then want to charge us $500 to get us back again. So we decided, no, we'll splash out. It's a once in a lifetime trip, just like Petra was. We're gonna go by the cruise ship. So we had this trip. They stopped on the way so we could have a bit of a comfort break. And then we got to Valley of the Kings. And then Valley of the Kings, first of all, they're extremely strict when it comes to cameras. You cannot take a camera onto the site. Now, I don't know why you can't take it onto the site. I know why you can't use photography in the tombs, but nope, they won't let you. In fact, they take your cameras away from you, and they can sometimes detain you if you have a camera. So there's a little booth area where you hand it in, you get a little ticket, you collect it afterwards. So no cameras on site. Absolutely not. Big time, no cameras, which is a shame, because of course, not that there's a lot to see, I have to say, it's mostly below ground. So yeah, very rough, very hot. And I wanted to go into Tutankhamun's tomb. My husband's like, I'm not paying extra money to go to Tutankhamun's tomb. He's a Yorkshireman. And he said, once you've seen one dummy, you've seen them all, or mummy. So he stayed up, but I paid to go into Tutankhamun's tomb. As a schoolgirl, I did a whole project on Tutankhamun, and I saw some of the artifacts when they came to London. Now, that's before most of yours time, but they did bring over the Tutankhamun exhibit to London, and my dad took me. So I was pretty small, and I'm 67 now, so it was a long, long time ago. It was probably 60 years ago. But because that was a fond memory for me, this project I did in school, when I got a bit older, and because I'd seen the exhibit, I wanted to go into the tomb. I'm glad we went. It was interesting. You didn't really see a great deal. There were hieroglyphics on the walls going down, so there's a lot of things to kind of make note of, and there were lots of different tombs which I took note of, but basically it's a graveyard, right? But I'm glad I went into Tutankhamun's tomb. I'm glad I went into the other tombs as well, most of which I can't remember, but it was very interesting. It's very old, of course, so it's interesting from that perspective. But then we left there and we went to another area, which was not tombs. It was actually the Temple of Karnak, and that was a lot of different ruins and big statues, and that actually was more impressive, if you're talking about visually impressive, than the Valley of the Kings. So Temple of Karnak, it was all part of the same tour. Then we went somewhere and got some lunch that was put on for us by the cruise line, of course, or the trip, and went back to the ship. It was a long, long day, but very interesting to hear some of the stories of how they uncovered the tombs and when they uncovered them, and a lot of the superstitions surrounding uncovering tombs. I'm sure you've seen things on the TV or documentaries. There's been a lot of superstition around digging out tombs or digging up graves. We didn't come across anything spooky while we were there. It was just hard work. Walking up after you walk down. Walking down was no problem. Walking up was like, it's a long way. But it was certainly worth doing. So would I go again? Nah, been there, done that, done it once. Just like Petra, no desire to go back again. But it's a tick off my list, and I'm glad I went. And I'm glad I went via sea and not on a river cruise, because I do love my ocean cruises. So if this has been helpful to you, click the subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, notification bell if you'd like to know when I'm going to post the next video. And I'm Jan Oatbridge, I'm the Cruise Queen. Have an awesome day, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.